Okay, today is 7.3, which is adding and subtracting. Rational expressions. And the good news is 7.3, all the rational expressions that we'll be adding and subtracting have the same denominator. Okay, so that's the easiest case with adding and subtracting fractions. Okay, here's our overall rule. If I'm adding, if I have a fraction a over b plus, let's say, c over b, if they have the same denominator, which they will all have the same denominator in this section, all you have to do, guys, is combine this to a single fraction, keep that denominator, and then just simply add the top, a plus c. Okay? This is my rule for adding two fractions with the same denominator. And again, rational expressions are just fractions. Okay? All right, let's start off with this example. 10 over 3x plus 5 over 3x. If you are given this problem, the first thing to notice is we're adding two fractions. The second thing to notice is they already have like denominators. Okay? And that's great, because when the denominators are the same, that's most of the work. All I have to do is stick with this rule here. I'm going to keep the denominator, 3x, and I'm going to combine the numerators, 10 plus 5, okay? And what is 10 plus 5? 15. Then, once you guys have put it together into a single fraction, now it's your time to reduce, which is what we did all last section, okay? Can 15 over 3x be reduced at all? Sure, I mean, 3 goes into 15 five times, so I'm going to reduce this. And our final answer will be 5 over x. Okay. All right, let's take a look at this problem. 2x minus 10 over x minus 2. Plus 2x plus 2 over x minus 2. Okay. Just like the last example, it's two fractions. Both the fractions have the same denominator of x minus 2. Great. So what I'm going to do is combine it. You keep the denominator the same. It's still x minus 2. You don't do anything with that. Then you want to add everything in the top. So I have 2x minus 10 plus 2x plus 2. Okay? So you combine it. You have four terms up here now. All right, now in these four terms, I have a 2x, a 2x, a negative 10, and a 2. So you combine your like terms, okay? So 2x plus 2x is 4x. And negative 10 plus 2, what is negative 10 plus 2? Negative 8. All right, so now I'm at this point in the problem. I've combined my like terms in the numerator. Can anything be factored out of either of these? Up here, can I factor anything out? GCF would be 4, right. So let's take a 4 out. And what goes in parentheses? X minus 2. Isn't that nice? So I have 4 parentheses x minus 2 divided by x minus 2. Let's go ahead and put that in parentheses. And I can reduce that whole thing. So my final answer for this problem is just 4. Okay? So again, I'm adding fractions, but they already have the same denominator. Your rule is just to add all the stuff in the top together over that same denominator. Combine your like terms, it comes out to 4x minus 8 over x minus 2. Once you guys are down to a single fraction, then try to factor it, okay? In this case, we could factor a 4 out, and it worked out really nice because the x minus 2 is reduced, okay? Okay, let's try another one. A squared minus 2 over a plus b. Plus 2 minus b squared over a plus b. All right, you guys try that one out, so I'll give you a little bit of time. They both have a plus b as denominators, so do exactly what we did in the last problem. Okay, so everybody should have done this for the first step. Just write down the denominator, write down all the terms in the numerator. A squared minus 2 plus 2 minus b squared, well, minus 2 plus 2, that goes away, right? Negative 2 plus 2 is just 0. So your next step should look like this. A squared minus b squared over a plus b. In this form, you can do nothing, okay? There's nothing that I can do in this form. But hopefully we recognize that a squared minus b squared is a difference of squares, and that factors a minus b, a plus b. Once we see that, then we can reduce it with this a plus b in the bottom, okay? But again, once I get it down to a single fraction, can any of this be factored? A squared minus b squared is a difference of squares, and that factors a minus b, a plus b, and that works out great because we have an a plus b downstairs waiting to get reduced, okay? So your overall answer for that one was just a minus b. That is adding rational expressions. That's pretty easy, okay? To add rational expressions with the same denominator, to keep the denominator, combine all the terms at the top, get it down to a single fraction, and then factor and reduce. That's it, okay? All right, let's look at subtracting. Subtracting is a little bit more difficult. Okay, with subtracting, the biggest note here, so I'll put a little star, is your minus sign gets distributed to all the terms in the second fraction, okay? So minus sign, or the subtraction symbol, gets distributed to every term in the second fraction. That's the biggest mistake students make when they're subtracting, is not doing this, okay? And let's see what I mean. Let's say we have this example, 2x plus 4 over x minus 2 minus 10 minus x over x minus 2. Okay? Here's a perfect example. So it's just like the problems we've been doing, but now I have a minus sign between them. Okay? So your rule is, just like before, you keep the x minus 2, and then we want to combine the numbers in the top. Okay? Now the biggest thing that students make a mistake is this minus sign goes with both of these terms, okay? So the best way to handle this, guys, is to just put 2x plus 4 minus, and then just make sure to put that 10 minus x in parentheses as a reminder to you, hey, I have to make sure this minus sign distributes with both of those, okay? If you don't put that parentheses around there, you're going to forget that that minus is going to change this minus into a plus, and then you'll have a mistake, okay? So I'm just basically begging you to make sure to put a parentheses around the second set of terms to indicate that you have to distribute that minus sign. Okay, so let's do that. So this becomes 2x plus 4. This minus sign is going to distribute. It'll become minus 10 and plus x, all divided by x minus 2. Okay? Once you avoid that mistake, then you just combine the stuff in the top like you have been. So 2x plus 4 minus 10 plus x. 2x plus x is 3x. What is positive 4 minus 10? Negative 6 over x minus 2. Great. At this point, I can factor a 3 out of the numerator. So let's factor a 3 out of the numerator. We get 3 parentheses x minus 2, and again, we've been getting really lucky on these problems. We've produced a common factor of x minus 2, which I'm able to reduce out. And my overall answer is just 3. Okay? But the biggest mistake is right here. that minus sign gets distributed with everything in the second fraction. Okay, let's try this one. Five x minus three over two x minus 3x minus 7 over 2x. Go ahead, do that one. Make sure to distribute that minus sign. Distribute that minus sign, get it to a single fraction, and then factor it. Your first step, minus, parentheses. Second step, distribute that minus. So minus 3x plus 7. Okay, did everybody get to that point?
Yes.
So that's the biggest mistake, is forgetting that parentheses, which makes you distribute that minus sign, okay? From here, 5x minus 3x is 2x. Negative 3 plus 7 is plus 10, divided by 2x, okay? Again, you cannot cancel at that point because you have terms. You must create factors. So you have two parentheses, x plus five.
It's minus three plus seven.
It should
be four. Oh, I'm sorry. I was testing you guys. You guys are awesome. Two x plus four, x plus two. Okay, do we have this? Two parentheses, x plus two divided by 2x. Now at this point, these are factors. This times this, this times this, then you can reduce. That 2 goes away, that 2 goes away. Your final answer is x plus 2 over x. Okay? Don't ever reduce terms. You can only reduce factors. So you have to factor, which is all of chapter 6, you know? Lovely 100 pages on how to factor. Any questions? Okay. And we are done with lectures for this whole class.